Yep, that's me. You're probably wondering how I ended up in this situation.
1998. I'll never forget it.
Resident Evil 4 begins with a recap that reminds us of the previous Resident Evil games, which is a bold move, because those games are fucking golden, and Capcom decided that for this one they'd remove all the zombies, change up the genre entirely, and completely overhaul the gameplay. Luckily though, these decisions resulted in one of the best games of all Why is he moving like that? Anyway, into the recap. The year is 2004, so Leon is, of course, listening to Avril Lavigne, and consequently doesn't hear these two cops chatting shit about him. It does not help that this game has no subtitles. No need to worry, Leon, they are NPC cops in a Resident Evil game. They won't be around for long. In the car, Leon explains that, following his escape from Raccoon City, he was handed a pretty hefty promotion from rookie local cop to top secret service agent working directly for the President of the United States of America. Great job, little guy. More specifically, he is in charge of defending the daughter of POTUS. The DOTUS, if you will, and she's been taken. Leon is doing a bad job. In fairness, this is literally his first day on the job. Wait, the Raccoon City incident was also on his first day on the... Don't hire this man! The only person less qualified to keep someone safe was his predecessor, Mario Mario, and he's pretty poor at preventing princesses from being kidnapped. Leon takes out his headphones and immediately hears about a calling competition on the car radio, but they've reached his destination, so he calls from outside. Hi, Leon S. Kennedy. You're on the Hunnigan Show. Can you hear me today, Leon? How do you know my name? Very good. So you've called in as part of our trivia trial. Do you reckon you have what it takes to win our grand prize today? What's the prize? Ah, straight to the point, I see. So, if you can answer our three trivia time questions this afternoon, you'll win a free ride in my very own private helicopter. A helicopter? That's right. Are you able to stay on the line? I don't have anything on. Alright, well, Leon, that's what we like to hear, but let's first hear a few words from our sponsors. I should probably look for the girl.
Not that way, cowboy. Not that way, cowboy.
Leon is not the sharpest tool in the shed. A man. Maybe he'll know where DOTUS is. Excuse me, sir? You seem like you're in charge around here. Oh, right, you probably don't speak American. Mano in charge? El Big Cheese. Have you seen the DOTUS?
¿Qué carajo estás haciendo aquí? Lárgate, cabrón!
From now on, Leon is going to kill anyone and everyone who knows even a word of Spanish. Oh no, a diplomatic incident. He's not a zombie. Well, that's not gonna help your case, is it? Well, that was easy. Leon likes to say that after everything he does. Bigging up his achievements is how he went from regional nervous newbie to government-issued one-man army in just two residents. Leon checks on the corpse and finds out that they're dead, told ya, before saving a trapped dog. It just runs off, ungrateful little shit. Guess we won't be seeing him again. Oh, and of course he kills a bunch of random villagers too.
Bingo?
Are you still there? I'm here. Well, let's get to it. Your first question, and remember now, if you get it wrong, you're out, is this. What animal-based faux pas led to production being shut down for 3 days during the filming of the original Dr. Dolittle? Easy. A giraffe stepped on its own penis. What's next? We didn't expect you to get that. Let me call you back. I want that helicopter ride, Hunnigan. Leon gets distracted shooting medallions and then finds the barn from the Muppet movie, but sadly still no sign of his boss's daughter, so he moves on.
Oh for fuck's sake, Chris, how many times?
After a few more fights, Leon meets a man who's been bound and gagged. Now, this man is Spanish, but recognizing Leon's obvious Americanness, he speaks English to him, and Leon is immediately on his side, which thankfully is also Leon's side. Leon asks him his name, but they're interrupted by a low frame rate, and also El Big Cheese, who wipes Leon the fuck out. I don't know what I don't think this is important. Leon wakes up tied to the mysterious English-speaking man from before and says, "Hey, you wanna tell me your name?" To which the man responds,
"Americano."
Before informing Leon that the president's daughter is locked up in a church and that there's a secret passage in the village that leads there. After the pair are freed by a helpful villager, Americano runs away and Leon prepares to head back to the village, but he's stopped by a cryptic cloaked individual who tells him to follow him down an alley. Now, Leon's mother always told him not to follow strange men into unknown places, but Leon figures that the worst that this guy could do is try to kill him, and it's like, get in line, eh, pal? Turns out the guy is a merchant.
What are you buying?
Rifle scope, treasure map. Leon will do this like 50 times throughout this game. His knees must be like jelly. In the village, Leon encounters a puzzle. It will not be the last, but he is accustomed to puzzles after starring in a previous Resident Evil, and solving it allows him into the only nice house in the game. It has a bookshelf and normal food and a urinal. Why did I say that? Like, Perry the urinal? Leon hears what he considers to be some evil Spanish whispering and tries to listen in, but his eavesdropping is rudely interrupted.
"You'll never be Mr. X."
One day, Leon won't be snuck up on by the biggest guy he's ever seen in his life, but today is not that day. Fortunately though, Mr. Big stares deep into Leon's eyes and falls desperately in love with him, renouncing his life of crime and committing to a married existence together in America. He just has to go and pack his things. Then Hunnigan calls again. "Hi Leon, welcome back to the show. How are you doing today?" "I wish my father..." That's great, that's great. Are you ready for your next question? You bet. Question 2. What was the name of the reindeer that spent 6 weeks on the British submarine HMS Trident during the Second World War? What, you think I'm some kind of amateur? The answer is Pollyanna. Lock it in, Hunnigan. That's fine. We'll get back to you when we have a third question. Time to find that church. The merchant is selling his wares in this secret underground tunnel, which seems like a bad business decision, but then again, I will give him all of my Peters in exchange for like a slightly bigger bag. So, what can I say?
What are you buying?
Weapon upgrades. The church. But Leon ignores his mission because there's a puzzle hidden behind the building. Oh no, the door is locked. Not like there are any windows or anything. Alice wouldn't let this get in her way. Anyway, Leon's Secret Service instincts tell him to run off randomly in this direction, so he does. And there he finds a letter. Something about a cure, or a vaccine, or a sample, or... He's not reading all of that. He does notice that nobody ever signs their names, though. And that makes him sad. What are they hiding from? What are they ashamed of?
Chris!
After a brief swim in a swamp, Leon finds a large lake where some of the locals are leaving their... yard trimmings. Upon seeing a giant salamander eating them, and reading about how nobody could possibly cross the lake alive, Leon decides not to go back and find another way into the church, and instead decides to take up pedalo. Sadly, all they have is a real boat. Uh-oh. Get speared, dickwad. Yeah, I'd be pretty tired too. Leon wakes up and something's wrong. Dear God, he wants to start a manager career with Oxford United. And this is weird. Leon is more of a new star soccer kind of guy. People's heads are turning into squids now. And look how terrified Leon is, the poor little fella. Can't even shoot a man's head off in peace.
Look at the size of that fucker.
Leon is just glad that this giant wasn't able to get the drop on him. The yelling locals gave it away, I reckon. Leon's like, aha, the mano in charge, and immediately gets violent. A dog shows up to help our hero, but he's never even seen this mutt before in his life. I don't know who you are. Stop glomming on. Anyway, we kill the big lad, well that was easy, and off to the rescue. We got the round thing that needed to go in the church door somewhere, I'm not quite sure where that was. And then we solve another puzzle, and finally, we've rescued the president's daughter. Great game, what? We have to get her back home? Ugh. Fine. DOTUS initially shows a healthy distrust of strange men showing up and trying to take her away, but will trust Leon with her life the moment he mentions her father. I don't think it's too much of a stretch to say that that makes her the most abductable person on planet Earth. And what do you know, I'm right. Plus, she's been infected. I mean, better to save yourself the trouble altogether. But no, Leon is a better man than me, so he and his rescuee together flee and Texas Chainsaw Massacre their way through a nearby window. Now, Leon does have to protect Dotus, which is annoying, but luckily he can like leave her in places and come back for her later, and he won't have to keep an eye on her for that long, trust me. Phone call. Hey, it's me. Hunnigan, I've been wondering, what is this show anyway? Why do people listen? Leon, I'm gonna have to stop you there because I have some bad news. I'd rather not hear it. We've lost contact with the chopper. Someone must have shot it down. Oh, no, I see what you're doing. You can't get out of that helicopter ride, Hunnigan. Okay, we are working on a replacement as we speak. Meanwhile, I need to get back to work on that third question. Oh no. Villagers. They want to politely ask Leon to stop making YouTube videos about the differences between Spain and Missouri. Leon does not oblige. Instead, he puts his headphones back in, and he and the president's daughter take shelter in a nearby building. And what do you know? Americano is here. And he's a pervert? Leon is also a pervert, apparently, because he jumped down a ladder, I guess.
Oh, you pervert!
Americano says, what are we gonna do about the Los Illuminados? And Leon's like, the who? And Americano says, no, the Los Illuminados. And Leon says, oh, I prefer Peter Andre. To which Americano says, yeah, I noticed. You should probably turn that off. Someone could get hurt if you're listening to music instead of keeping an ear out. No. Americano claims that he lost something and then just leaves. I don't think he's a fan of Mysterious Girl. Hide in this bin, Miss President. I need to go kill some folks. I also went back and killed the troll because I am an elite player who definitely isn't terrible at this game. Need I? Cable car, bebe. Leon sends his dependent away just before the fight with Father Mendez because frankly he's tired of listening to her and wants to get back to his sweet early noughties tunes. If anything, Americano was right and the music just helps the big man get the drop on Leon yet again. I'm getting deja vu here. As we watch this lover's embrace, I should probably address the weird third wheel elephant in the room, which is the weird flirty vibe that Dotus has when she's talking to Leon. The problem is that Leon is in full-on Taken mode and is spending what little brain power remains on trying, and failing, to think up some comebacks for when one of the villains inevitably throws an insult his way. Meanwhile, Dotus's most recent watch was My Date with the President's Daughter, and she's doing her best to stick to that script and channel its specific energy. It's a fatal incompatibility, and it's why it can never work between them. That and the fact that she's like max 15. Maxis? Leon has trapped Father Mendez in a swimming pool with no exit ladder. Delightfully devilish, Kennedy. Leon has also taken the time to make himself a grilled cheese, because he's not eaten since the in-flight snacks on the way over, and the old woman in the seat next to him accidentally stole his bread roll. Between that and killing like 400 guys, he's in dire need of some lunch. Well, that was easy. Oh no, a truck. I've never played this game and not died here, which is a bit embarrassing, but just goes to show that no evil can truly compare to the power of modern engineering. Get drawbridged, you assholes. Cannons, like keys, but for people with self-respect. Okay, Leon, we finally have it. A question to challenge your superior trivia knowledge. Hit me. By how many points did the American athlete Jim Thorpe win the decathlon event at the 1912 Olympics in Stockholm? Wait. I know this. Hunnigan, you best get that chopper ready because... Hunnigan... Hunnigan! Leon, I'd like to go now.
Leon! I've got something for you guys.
As I say, Americano is a pervert. Let's get out of here. Leon finds a key and heads inside and is immediately accosted by this fucking cosplayer called Salazar. He says something about, like, architecture, I don't know. Sadly, this is a cutscene and not a boss fight, so Leon can't just shoot this weird dickhead like he did with everyone in the village.
I've been expecting you, my brethren.
For the rest of the game, Leon will speak exclusively in non sequiturs.
No thanks, bro.
Salazar also calls Leon Mr. Scott, and apparently this is worthy of a mic drop. I don't know about that one, guy. Oh look, you have to collect 3 animal heads to open this door, because this game is a cheap imitation of the Japanese game Biohazard 7. That's right, gamers, I know about the Biohazard series. On their way to find the heads, Leon and what's-her-name end up in a dungeon. There is a scary enemy here, but he is blind, so you just need to be quiet to avoid him. Under his breath, so as not to be heard, Leon mutters, "You seem like you're in charge around here." This fight happens at about 0.5 miles an hour. It's worth it though, because he's carrying 15,000 peters, and that's cash money, baby. Also, for some reason, the dungeon has the lever to stop these horses from breathing fire, so now we can continue into the rest of the building. The enemies here are also tougher than the villagers, and that, my friend, is the power of faith. Next, Leon finds the merchant dude again, in this room that exists entirely outside of space and time. The man offers us infinite free attempts at a shooting range game with his own guns and ammunition, and if we win, he'll give us trophies and huge amounts of money. It seems too good to be true, but it's not, because this guy's a fucking legend. Dotus wants to go home, probably because this mysterious cloaked man has several cardboard cutouts of her, but Leon has already demonstrated that he's highly competitive and can't turn down the chance to win a prize. He will do this 3 more times later on. Sick of Leon's shit though, the Dotus tries to leave and immediately walks into a death trap. Luckily, she's agile enough to avoid all the pointy bits. Unluckily, she stands in exactly the wrong spot in this wall and is about to be captured again. You want to move out of that obvious trap, Mr. President's daughter? No? I think she's trying to get captured.
Hunnigan, Dotus has Stockholm Syndrome. I'm afraid she'll have to the vaccine. Oh well, yeah, I'll get that. Wait, Hunnigan? You're on the Hunnigan show, that's like my favourite— Oh, it's you. Hey, so are you like an old man, or just a child in a Napoleon costume? Salazar hung up on me. There's always one incredibly annoying enemy type in a Resident Evil game. Oh, I'm an invisible bug, and I'm going to kick you. Get fucked. Los Illuminados are doing cult shit. No surprises there. But we should probably stop them, and... Oh. They're running. It feels less good shooting them in the back, to be honest. At least until you loot them anyway. Why is there a window here? This does not seem in keeping with the architecture. Why is there a Gatling gun here? This does not seem in keeping with the architecture. Oh look, it's Salazar. He gets Leon's name right this time, and Leon, for his part, delivers one of those one-liners that he's been working on, and then some folks with scythes appear, some folks with crossbows appear, some folks with RPGs appear, and Leon gets the goat head. Time to meet Ada. First, though, Salazar calls, and he's like, "Just so you know, Leon, it's not cool to make fun of my diminutive stature like you did. I know that I'm trying to kill you and all, but let's not be body-shaming here, eh?" Leon apologizes, and all is well. Salazar won't try to hurt us anymore. I used to be scared of this maze, but then I remembered that I had a map, and that dogs are allergic to bullets. Wait, those were Salazar's dogs. Shit, I think the truce might be off. Ada! When Ada shows up, Leon is a little surprised. Oh, gross, it's you. Didn't I shoot you already? Also, you fell into a bottomless pit. I was rescued by the new rescue helicopter. A woman has fallen into the abyss in Raccoon City. Well, what are you doing here? That doesn't concern you, you feeble-minded little dweeb. Okay, ouch. I just thought because I'm here for the president's daughter that, you know, maybe we could work together. Wait, you're here for Dotus? Yeah. Ugh, you creep. She's like max 15. What? No, I... Fuck you, I'm out of here. Needless to say, this was not the reunion that Leon had hoped for. And to make things worse, the merchant was standing right there the whole time. She, like, totally wants to have sex with me.
What are you buying?
Revolver. Enemies, enemies, enemies. Actually, seeing as there's no Dotus around, Leon decides to listen to his tunes again. Much better than the constant of the cultists. Oh hey, look, it's Americano. And he found what he was looking for. Oh, that's not good. If only he'd been doing the cha-cha slide. He would have been sliding to the left at just the right time. This tentacle is hidden where? This isn't even a dick joke, there's no way. Surely. Oh, right, Americano is dying. He gives us some medicine, because apparently Leon and Dotus are infested with the same parasites as everyone else in the— No, that's too much exposition. Shit. I really kind of liked that guy. Oh look, it's Dotus. She's still in the same trap. What the fuck? Ow, Jesus. Now I see why they didn't come near you. Fair play, that's actually quite a good defense mechanism. Make no mistake, Leon does consider ending her at this point. Several cultists have the same idea though, and ultimately he decides not to side with them. Dotus escapes through a nearby door, and now we have no weapons. Or health. Or anything. Surprising then that this part of the game is actually good. Oh Christ, I have been so bad at these puzzles my whole entire life. Cool serpent head. Oh yeah, I need it for the door. Oh great, now the castle itself is trying to kill me. We made it. Are you blocking my signal? You killed my dogs, you asshole. Salazar, I need that signal to go on the Hunnigan show and win my free helicopter ride. I'll give you a shout out if you want. Oh, we know all about the helicopter ride, Mr. Kennedy. Hunnigan's been telling all of her listeners about how she's upping the stakes. She's procured the new rescue helicopter itself. And if you don't call her back with the answer before the end of tonight's show, she's going to start again and give the prize to another guest. And you best believe I've been brushing up on my trivia. But I know the answer, Salazar. I know how many points he won by. Tell that to Hunnigan, Mr. Kennedy. Tell that to her. Suddenly, there is a hitherto unseen urgency on Leon's part. He leaves Dotus behind so that he can go and slay some dragons, and in doing so, he finds the lion's head, allowing him to open the big door to the next area. There's another shooting range here, though, and as we know, Leon can't turn down a challenge, so he's running even further behind schedule when he bumps into Salazar yet again. Salazar won't let Leon back on the show, so he locks us in a room, and to add injury to insult, the room is a death trap. Oh no, looks like we're going to have to do a big boss fight against these guys and a giant oh, it's done. Shoot some suits, collect some cups, there's a snake in my box, wait a fucking second, and then we are here, a room containing the Thorian from Mass Effect. Dotus allows herself to be captured again, big fucking surprise, and after killing a bunch of bugs, Leon is starting to get offended. Would she really rather spend her life with these grotesque cultists and zombie parasites than with him? Like, he's gonna smell pretty bad by this point, but surely they can't be much better. Besides, he's fairly sure that Salazar uses Lynx Africa, and what could be worse than that? All of this losing the president's daughter has Leon thinking that maybe he's not cut out for this Secret Service malarkey, and that idea makes him a little depressed. Thankfully though, the very next person he sees is the merchant, and this cheers him up.
Got some rare things on sale, stranger.
Thanks, Mr. Merchant, sir. I really needed this.
Any time.
Well, on the bright side, she's alive. Damn! They've blocked our path by jamming the gears in the clock tower that controls the rotating bridge that we need to cross to get to where she's being held. Thank God they left this note here that conveniently explains all of that, or this could have been a serious hurdle. You've eaten your last burrito, pal. What? You know, because you're Mexican. We're not Mexican, we're Spanish. What? Why are all you Spaniards in Mexico? This is Spain, guy. Oh, not to mention that it's quite offensive to just associate. Let me think of a new one. Okay. Something about Corsica. Jesus Christ, man. Aha, you heard it. Just like that, Leon converted this guy back to Christianity. They shook hands and went their separate ways. Not these guys though, these fuckers had to die. Leon catches up to Salazar and co, but it's not time to kill them yet.
You are the weakest link, Mr. Kennedy. Goodbye.
And then Leon says an insult so shocking and cruel that I couldn't possibly... Ah, what the hell, here it is. Salazar, I think your outfit is silly.
How dare you! No more games! Kill him!
Can't kill me, there's a merchant here.
What are you buying?
Striker and upgrades, please, Mr. Merchant Man. Oh shit, it's this bit. Let me go back and get a rocket launcher. Ice to see you. Oh hell yeah, shooting range. I could do this all day. Wait, no, the president's daughter. Why is there always a mineshaft? Dead, 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 dead. Now we're in a lava room. Definitely not some sort of arena. Oh no, enemies. Luckily, we can melt one, and the other doesn't take too long either. Leon is frighteningly powerful at this point. Kill some bugs and melt this door. Seems impractical, but then again, keys are for nerds. Ada has left us a note. It says to kill the president's daughter. That can't be right. It also says that a hatched parasite can only be removed through a careful surgery that's likely to kill the host. Remember that when we get Dotus to do it later. Oh look, we need another weird key. So far, the main requirements for being in this cult seem to be saying go, ki, go, and forgetting how fucking doors work. Leon kills some more villagers and then desecrates a grave before yet another spiky ceiling tries to turn him into a Leon Sandwit minecart chase. Very good, very fun, QTE, and boom, we've found the key. Open up the door and up we go. For some reason, Salazar has a giant statue of himself that can do the Macarena. And when I say for some reason, I mean for some reason I don't have one of these. It's a good thing Leon learned to jump in the years since Raccoon City. Must have been the Secret Service training. Okay, look, on the one hand, I know he's not technically Secret Service, but on the other hand, I don't particularly care. I probably shouldn't have woken him up. So nice you could join us, Mr. Scott Kennedy. Well, I guess that confrontation comes later. Luckily, there is a lift, and we don't have to dodge barrels forever. I did drop a few extra though, mainly just for fun.
What are you buying?
Revolver and upgrades. I'll probably need them for some big boss fight that's about to happen. Ugh. Mr. Kennedy. Salazar, you give me back my signal and you let the girl go. Not a chance. I will be taking her with me on my ride in the new rescue helicopter. Why, Salazar? Why her? We got really unlucky. We thought nobody would miss her. We didn't realize who she was. I was referring to the new rescue helicopter. Oh, well, you were annoying me, so I figured I'd take everything you have. Well, you never took my memory, Salazar. There's no way your trivia book can replace years of training. Try me, Mr. Scott. Any subject, any question. Oh, really? You willing to bet your life on it? It's a deal. Leon thinks for a second. What is my first name? I don't know that one. Salazar is dead, but Dotus has already been taken to the cult leader Sadler on a nearby island. Someone should give her a fucking anchor or something. I mean, this is ridiculous. But luckily, we can get there in a nearby speedboat. Well, hi. Oh, it's you. I thought you were my date. You have a date? What was his name? Salazar. I have bad news. And you just fucking killed him? I don't remember your name, man. Are you gonna do the same to me? Look, you shouldn't bet your life if you're not willing to lose it. Ugh, whatever, man. I can't believe I got dressed up for nothing. Ada flashes Leon and then grapnel boosts her way up the cliffs, crashing the boat in the process. Leon is left to walk and is further annoyed to find that he still can't get through to the radio show. I miss Hunnigan. I've been playing too much Metro. Oh good, a machine gunner. Fuck you and fuck your hat. The island is full of weird military-infected soldier prisoners with lightning rods. No matter, Leon will kill them all anyway. What's that sound? Oh god. She has literally no reason to believe that I'm here, so has she just been constantly crying for me ever since that bug took her? Jeezy Pete, no wonder all the locals are murderous. Why is the CCTV in this prison controlled from inside the cell? Shooting range. This is the last one, but Leon once again passes with flying colours, and is now a very rich man. Or he was, until he splurged it all on a tactical vest. Probably a good investment, but still. Shit. Regenerators. Oh look, a note explaining how to kill them, left here by someone called... Louise? How helpful. Get yourself the thermal scope, and you're ready to drop these immortal bastards. Speaking of dropping... Come on, Hunnigan, come on, there must be some sort of phone around here. Oh, Dotus. Yeah, I was looking for you. Fantastic, they have spikes now. Anyway, we free the president's daughter, and then we get a note from Ada. It tells us that we belong in the trash. Anyway, Leon leaves the building through the door, like a normal person would. And then, he sees it. A radio tower. He checks his watch. It's almost too late, but he just about has time. Hunnigan, it's me, Leon. The answer is 688 points. Jim Thorpe won by 688 points. Reading you loud and clear, Leon. Congratulations on winning a free ride in the new rescue helicopter. We'll send it to you right away. Oh my god. Oh my god, it's happening. Better get somewhere safe to land. And if that means another chase in a bigger, better minecart, then so be it. Are you sure you're qualified to operate one of these? Phew, we made it. There's a helipad just out of our way, Sadler. Sadler uses his Sith powers to stop Leon's attack, and then Dotus just... Okay, she's not even hiding it anymore. She's definitely in on the kidnapping plot. Oh well, back to square one. Meanwhile, Ada is talking to some guy who... I have absolutely no idea who this is. Let's have a look on IMDb and see what he's... Sorry, I'm getting distracted. Leon kills some more fetishists and then hears a sound. What do you want?
My long-lost son, Dale Dimmadome, heir to the Dimmsdale Dimmadome fortune.
I don't have him, so see ya.
Adios!
Then Sadler calls and tells us that we have to fight something which he simply refers to as it. But first, lasers. And throne. Lift downstairs, and it's time to fight this thing on... This place cannot be up to code. This is it. I hate it. I have no jokes about it. I'm so glad that it's dead, and I'd kill it again if I could bear to look at it for a second longer. Oh, for fuck's sake. This is literally the fourth time in a Resident Evil game that I've switched to a Magnum late on in a big fight and immediately killed the fucker. When will I learn to just use it from the start? Never. I like hoarding. 50,000! I love you, it! Then we enter these ruins, which are iconic and well known amongst fans of the series because nothing happens here. Whew, nearly wrecked myself into a corner there. Holy heck, that's a lot of guys. How am I gonna- The new rescue helicopter! Hey! Easiest fight of my life. The chopper did it all for me. Now for him to land so that I can climb a boar. No! Lego City will never recover from this. Oh well, let's go find Dotus. Ada is here and Leon is looking a bit worse for wear. Leon, what are you doing? This is not how you ask for her number. Ada stabs him, which seems fair enough, and then says that she'll be killing the president's daughter, seeing as he's failed so miserably in that respect. He promises that he won't let that happen, but he did just get stabbed, so he needs a couple of minutes to recover. And surprisingly, he gets there first, despite having to kill about 70 guys along the way. Leon frees Dotus, and Sadler's there too. Ada shows up and tries to shoot her victim in waiting, but misses, and get this, actually helps Leon get away. And what do you know? Leon has this child perform surgery on him to remove the parasite. That's definitely what happens here, do not correct me. Looks painful, says Dotus. Let me try. Once again sensing that something isn't right, Leon leaves her behind before the big fight. Some would say that that's a bad idea, given how easily she's been kidnapped, but it turns out to be the right move. Shit. Get craned, dick nips.
Ow, ow, ow. God, that hurts.
Ada gives us a big boomy thing, I think with the intention of destroying Dotus, but Leon decides to use it on Sadler instead. I can't believe I'm doing fucking inventory management right now. See ya, Sadler.
Well, that was easy.
Then Ada jumps off a building. What? No. No, it's the new rescue helicopter. Has she got to go on it again? Thanks for the free ride, Leon. I'm terrible at trivia games. Ada, that is my helicopter ride. And now she's blowing up the fucking island. Leon considers jumping himself so that he'll get rescued too, but somehow he doesn't think that'll happen. Besides, that idiot left him the key to her jet ski. Fucking moron. Anyway, better get moving. The game won't let you rescue the merchant instead of Dotus. What kind of bullshit is this? Oh well, the guy lives in an interdimensional shooting range. He'll probably be okay. Good thing this jet ski seats too, huh?
Ah, that's tender. Oh god, I'm in so much pain.
Once again, the jet ski segment killed me more than literally anything else in this entire game. We did it. Leon has rescued the president's daughter. Mission accomplished, right, Leon? Not yet. I still need that helicopter ride. And then, as Leon puts his headphones back in one last time, Dota says, redacted, yeah, that's Resident Evil 4. Is it the greatest game ever made? Well, no, that's Raft Wars, but it's still pretty good.
Hannigan, is that you? Finally, the line's jack free. I never got my new rescue helicopter ride, you know. It was stolen. Oh, I'm sorry to hear that, Leon. We'll sort that out for you right now. Thanks. You know, you sound kind of cute now that nobody's trying to kill me. Give me your number when I get banned, flight cancelled.